Hello everyone, this is Sudipta from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how you can connect your Salesforce with N8N, where on every Salesforce account creation, the N8N trigger will work and send a consolidated email to my Gmail account using ChatGPT. So without any further delay, let's build this workflow connecting Salesforce with N8N. Okay, so let's understand the use case before we implement that. So the use case is my user will insert the account record in Salesforce. The moment the account record is created in Salesforce, what it will do, it will trigger the automation in N8N. And what the automation will do, it will pass few of the account attributes to ChatGPT and gather some information from ChatGPT. And finally, it will consolidate those information and send an email to the proper audience. So a very simple use case, but the intention is to demonstrate how to integrate Salesforce with N8N and bring the automation in life. So let's build this automation in N8N workflow. So as you can see, I am in my N8N workflow overview page, and this is my Salesforce account. So the first thing that I'm going to do, I'm going to create a new workflow. For that, I'll click on this create workflow button and it will bring this page. So the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to click on this plus sign to add my first step. And in the search node, I'm going to search for Salesforce. And from the search result, I'll select Salesforce here. And here, there are multiple triggers available inside Salesforce, but for my use case, it will be on account created. So I'll select the first one. The moment I select the first one, what it's telling me to do, to connect N8N with Salesforce. And it's a very simple step to connect your Salesforce with N8N. All you need to do is under this credential to connect with, you need to click on this drop down and then click on create new credential. And here, depending on whether you're connecting to production or your sandbox, you need to select either production or sandbox. For me, it's a developer or, so that's why I'm choosing production and click on connect my account. It will open up the pop-up. Here you need to give your username and password. For me, it's already open. That's why it's connected automatically. And now my Salesforce is connected to N8N. So the moment Salesforce is connected to N8N, here, this is some configuration that you can do. How frequently you want your N8N to do the polling. So here are multiple options available. For example, every minute, every hour, every day. In my case, I'm doing every minute. So every minute, what N8N is going to do, N8N is going to check Salesforce and try to find out if there is any new account created. For my situation, it's on account create. So this is the one. What you can do, you can click on fetch test event, and as you can see, it actually brought an event from my Salesforce org. So far, so good. Okay, so once the Salesforce node is configured, what I'm going to do, I'm going to click on this plus sign to add my AI agent. So I'm going to click on this plus sign, and in the search node, I'm going to search for AI agent and bring this AI agent here. So here, first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to source for the prompt. This is the prompt which I'm going to pass to my model, which is ChatGPT here. In the AI agent, what I'm going to do, I'm going to configure the prompt. Now, prompt is something which I'm going to pass to ChatGPT, my model, to get some information about my company. So here, the source of the prompt, I'm going to select, I'm going to define my own prompt. So what I am doing is that this is what is going to be my prompt. Can you please find the below information about the company named, and here is the company name, this is the tag I'm that passing here. Can you please find the below information about the company name this? What are the information I'm looking for? Where is the headquarters? How many employees? And third is, when was the company started? Once you have all this information, can you please consolidate them and send it to email address? Uh, Okay, so that's my prompt. So let's review the prompt. Prompt is, I'm asking ChatGPT. ChatGPT is going to be a model, and I'm going to show you very quickly how you can configure this in this video. So let's, for the timing, let's assume ChatGPT is going to be a model, and I'm going to pass the prompt to ChatGPT. The prompt is, can you please find the below information about the company named this? Where is the headquarter, how many employees, and when was the company started? And finally, I'm asking ChatGPT, once you have all this information, please consolidate them and send it to my email address, which is sudipta.dev@gmail.com. So far, so good. And then, looks good. And here in the chat model, once this is done, in the chat model, I'm clicking on plus sign. And here, I'm going to search for Open and OpenAI chat model. Now, OpenAI chat model, I already have my OpenAI configured. So I'm going to select that. And from the model, I'm going to select the GPT-4, which is good enough. And then once I pass the prompt to my ChatGPT, the whatever the information that is being gathered, I want to send an email, right? So for that, under the tool, I'm going to click on plus sign and select Gmail. Now here, if you are facing any problem or you don't know how to configure Google Auth with N8N, I have a dedicated video for that. I'll put the link in the description as well as the top right corner. Highly recommended that you go and watch that video, because there is a slightly process change recently introduced by N8N. So it's very important that you watch the video and configure Google Auth with N8N. So let's assume that you have done that already. So select Google Auth Gmail account here. All these are, looks good. In the to section, I can give my email address, but what I want, basically, I want my model to define what is going to be the to. So for that, I'm going to click on this sign, which is basically let the model define the parameter, who will be the to. Similar in the subject line, all I'm planning to do is that I want ChatGPT to decide what is going to be my subject line. So I'm going to click on that. In the email type, I'm going to select text, and in the message, again, I want my model to define the message. So far, so good. Everything looks good. And all I'm doing is that I'm going to save this flow and I'm going to mark this active. The reason for mark this active is that now this node is going to poll Salesforce org every 1 minute and try to find out if there is any new account is created or not. So let's go to the execution. And let's go to my Salesforce account and let's create a new account called Google and click on save. Now let's come back to the execution and let's wait for this automation to trigger. So it will trigger very soon. Okay, seems like my execution has started. And here is the execution. And seems like this Gmail node has not executed. Let's find out the reason. Okay, I think the wrong is here. It is not able to define the subject. So let me put my subject by myself. Okay, so I'm going to delete that and I'm going to put my own subject, which is information about new company, and then this is the one. Information of the new company looks good. Click on save. It's already active. So now let's go back here. Let's delete this account and let's create a new account called Tesla. Click on save. Now let's go back here and let's wait for this execution, this automation to be triggered. Okay, seems like my automation has triggered. So let's click on that. And this time the Gmail, this node also executed, because you see a green tick. I can see there is a new email that came up, which is about information of the new company Tesla. This is information, this is the number of employees, and this is when it was founded. This is the way how you can easily create your automation with N8N. But I want to make this also, instead of a hard-coded text, I want to make this also as coming from my model. So for that, all I need to do, I need to modify my prompt. So here, once you have all the information, can you please consolidate the and send it to email with the subject information about new company, and then inside that I'm going to put this. Okay, so now I have modified my prompt. So let's see, save that and let's make it active. Now let's go back to my account and let's create a new account called Google and click on save. Now when I come back and click on execution, I'll wait for the new execution to start. So let's see. Okay, looks like there is a new execution started. So let's wait for that to finish. Yep, this time it happened. The Gmail node executed successfully. So let's go back to my Gmail. And here is the information about Google. So everything came perfectly. So this is a way how you can easily create an automation connecting Salesforce with N8N. If you like this video, please share this with your friends, with your colleagues, so that they can build automation with Salesforce. And if you have built any automation connecting Salesforce with N8N, please share with me. I'll be more than happy to go and execute and review your automation. And finally, if you like this video, please hit the like icon and subscribe to my channel so that in future, when I'll be publishing more videos about N8N automations connecting with Salesforce, Google, or any other technology, you'll be the first person to be notified. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye.